Well, hello there. I'm Green Deane, and welcome back to my 19th video here on EatTheWeeds.com. Today we're going to talk about a choice edible, at least I think it is. It's called Smilax, a particular Smilax bona-nox. But there are 300 species of Smilax, so they go from Canada way down to South America, basically east of the Rockies. If you go to EatTheWeeds.com, there's a nice blog on there on Smilax. I went out yesterday and took a video of that on a particularly nice trail through here. But before we get to that, I want to show you four photographs about the Smilax to give you some better idea of the plant, and then we'll go look at the video and come back and itemize. How's that?
Smilax is a climbing shrub, but it looks like a vine. Leaves can be oval, elliptical, or shaped like a fat arrow. Stems can angle a little, as this one does, or be long and curving, as you will see in a little while. Now let's take a look at the berries. Here are some berries ranging from green to starting to ripen to black. They'll turn absolutely complete black when they're fully ripe. And in the green or black stage, you can still chew them like gum. Here's a typical view of a Smilax when it forms a bramble on the ground, which then usually climbs up to the nearest tree or fence to make a clump. Most esteemed of the Smilax for vegetable uses is the end of the bullbriar or the Smilax bona-nox. Let's take a look at it. The tip of the bullbriar kind of looks like the insect called a walking stick. Since the vine grows from the tip is the most tender part and the part we forage for. What you do is you grab a tip a foot or so from the end and see if it breaks easily when you bend it. If it doesn't, you move towards the tip a couple of inches and bend again. At some point it will snap clean, and that's the edible part. Now let's take a look of doing just that out in the field where they're growing.
Smilax. Smilax comes in several forms. I'm holding the camera here at the same time, so it's going to be a bit of a challenge. But here is a small Smilax, probably a latifolia or a laurelfolia, and it's in blossom right now. And it has little edible berries. They're not really eaten for nutrition. They're more like a gum. But above it is this very large briar, and this is called the Smilax bona-nox. You can see it's a very, very large vine, and it's also called the bullbriar. And it's called that because it has large, large thorns on it. Now, while the laurelfolia, or this little leaf Smilax down here, is not high on the list of foods, this one is, because it tastes very similar. One of those few things that actually does taste very similar to string beans once you cook it. And of course, we have a breeze out here today. The question is, how do you collect it? Tell whether it's edible. Well, there's another one over here, so let's take a look at this one. I'll start with this one. This is a much smaller one up here. So this is the smaller leaf one. Well, the style is the same. You come out and you lift, it won't break, you lift and won't break, and you pull, and the closer you get the end where it snaps, there it is. Now we'll just give this a little taste here. I'm looking to see me in the film or not. Let's go back to here. Look at this one. It's a much bigger one. So this is the, again, this is the Smilax bona-nox, pretty sure. And so we lift here, doesn't separate. We lift here, doesn't separate it right there. So here's the edible part we got, and that's pretty good. All of that's edible. By the way, the Smilax bona-nox has a root that, a large root that is red. Red, it has reddish starch in it. And it can be used for, you can eat it, you can make a beer out of it. You can use it to make, matter of fact, it's a cousin to the sarsaparilla. So let's see here if I can, let's see here if I can just turn this around. I don't know if you can see me or not, but I'm on the trail, sunny day, and I presume I'm in the camera. But here it is, Smilax. Now, sorry about that. Nothing any more here or not. Oh, yes there is. I see one right there. Way up here, see that? Get the sun in your eyes or not. Here's the end of another one. See? Another look at it.
again, you bend it so it won't break there. It won't break there. Oh, it did break there. So there we go. We have another lovely end of a Smilax. These are prolific weeds, so don't worry about eating them. Now, I think they taste a little better cooked, but anyways, I'll just give it a little try here. Pretty good. So, there's some more up there, but I don't think I'm going to climb up and get them. Got to leave some for other people. So here we are, out on the Okaiba Trail. By the way, that lady down there coming my way is my 84-year-old mother out taking a walk. So I have to stop snacking now, and we'll go back to our program. We now interrupt this program for an important message. Now we go back to our original scheduled program.
Well, you know, it was my mother who got me into foraging. When I was a kid, we'd go out into the forest, and she would eat this and eat that, and I'd ask her why, and she said, gee, my mother did it, so I'm a third-generation forager. And there might be something to it, because as I said, she's 84, she doesn't take a pill, and I think foraging brings a variety of plant life into your diet, and that can be quite good. In fact, my personal belief is that if your great-great-grandmother wouldn't recognize something as food, don't eat it. But, you know, that's my own particular view on that. Now, back to Smilax. Research shows that Smilax is good for, has some antiviral capacities, that is good for perhaps treating cognition issues and Alzheimer's. Very good plant. Now let's itemize. We itemize here at EatTheWeeds.com. First of all, it's a climbing shrub, although it really looks like a vine. It's a tough vine. It has tendrils that grow out of the leaf axils. It has varied shaped leaves, but they have parallel veins, and the vine has no pith to it. Now in the south, we keep the leaves all winter, but in northern climates, they lose the leaves in the wintertime. The flowers are small, green, and the fruit is green and turns to black. You can chew it when it's green for a gum. It's not so good when it's black. There's one species with red berries, and I would just kind of leave that one alone. Next is time of year. Springtime and summer. The tips and shoots are the best in the springtime, although the tip, actually the vine, it grows all season long, so you can almost get it up north from frost to frost. And of course, in southern states, you can have it almost all year round. It grows all season. Environment. Well, moist woodlands. It tolerates dry conditions, but it likes a nice temperate forest, although it grows well here in Florida in dry areas. It likes to climb fences, poles, trees, almost anything like that. And if there's nothing to grow on, it'll make a ball-like shrub. Method of preparation. The shoots and tips raw or the shoots and tips cooked? I think they're better off cooked. I think if you eat a lot of them raw, you might get a tummy ache. Young roots are good in soups and stews, and the berries are good as a gum when they're green. They're not so good when they're black. And of course, I would avoid the Smilax with red berries. It's one of my favorite foraging foods. I'm always looking for it. It's a great trail side nibble. You have enough of them, and you can get a lot of them. It's a great side dish. Once you learn to ID it, you'll see it everywhere, and really enjoy it. I'm Green Deane. I want to thank you for joining me in my 19th video. Of course, you can go to eattheweeds.com and read about this plant and all the other ones. And until next time, I want you to think green, eat green, and that includes Smilax.